Much before man walked the earth, in the world of Brahma, where nature was supreme, the first music was born when the wind whistled through the bamboos. It was in the timeless land of India that depicted the traverse bamboo held close to the lips of Lord Krishna, creating a mesmerizing celestial world for the gods and goddesses, the cowherd girls and their animals. This is the birth of the bansuri, the Indian bamboo flute.
Whenever I speak through my bamboo. And that's my, what do you call, desire, or that's my ultimate feeling. And everybody understands that. And I enjoy.
One can talk very little about geniuses like Hariji because it's the listening on his flute and personal relationship one has built, and also the warmth he gives on at every interaction, which is absolutely amazing. Hariji stands amongst one of the greatest, and not a day passes without hearing his concert, however short it may be for myself. Today, given that we are in the presence of not only two accomplished musicians, Panditji Hariprasad Chaurasia and Srimati Mala Ramadorai, but also many distinguished scientists studying nature in this unique atmosphere, created by Shri Ranjit Bhattakura Balipara Foundation, I would like to pose the question, how can man progress from being a mere wielder of tools to a sapient being? In short, how does one become a homo sapien in the 21st century? Let us listen attentively to some music, for there is indeed an elusive, ineffable quality to music, especially of Panditji, that cannot be captured in words, but only be felt deeply within oneself. Thank you so much.
We are honored to be here for this occasion and this event, and thanks to Balipara Foundation and family for the invitation. This is a kind of experience, beautiful experience for us, and thanks to Pandit Shubhankar Banerjee and Deopriya who are accompanying me, and thanks to Malaji to be here with me, supporting me. And I'm fortunate to have instrument like bamboo flute, which grows, bamboo grows here. Since last 65 years, I'm carrying this bamboo, which belongs to Assam, and I'm thankful to.
When you say music and the inspiration for music, for all music, I think comes from nature. It's really something that I think feeds off each other. Singing along with it. I'd love to sing with him. I mean, any opportunity to perform with him would be great. And he's always very accommodating and very understanding. So I said it'd be a lovely opportunity. It's a very natural progression, especially in Hindustani classical. It's something that is very individual, and it is something which is very deeply felt. It's an emotional reaction, actually, to the notes. All the notes are there. All the notes have to be very important. Some notes are more important and some notes are not. It's the same thing as in nature. In some places it's predominantly green, and some places there are flowers, and in some places there's a sand, and so the scenery and everything has got its own place and its own rhythm and its own kind of proportion. Appreciation of nature, appreciation of the world, and your emotional well-being and your happiness, your positivity, everything comes through the music. And so that, I think, is the most beautiful thing about music and nature. Everything beautiful has been relegated to some other smaller role, and everything useful has been given a bigger role now, unfortunately. What will make you money? But looking at it from the child's point of view, what will make him happy, or what is the skill that he has? That's what we should be asking, really. If this kind of a session is there, and if it's hard-hitting, factual, things which are actually happening, and a person who's actually involved, if they go and interact with children, I think the impact will be tremendous. It's very essential.